Hello students, in the previous session we have studied about the types of teeth, their function and about the tooth decay also. Today I am going to discuss some questions based on that topic. So first question is, how many types of teeth are formed in human being, found in human being? So there are four types of teeth in human being. These are called incisor, canine, premolar and molar. These are the four types of teeth found in humans. How many incisors are found in an adult human? There are 8 incisors, 4 in lower and 4 in upper jaw, found in an adult human. What is the function of incisors? Incisors are used to cut and bite the food. That's why they are also known as cutting or biting teeth. How many canines are found in an adult human? There are 4 canines found in an adult human. What is the function of canine? Canine are the type of teeth which help to hold and tear the food. That's why they are known as tearing teeth. How many premolars are there? There are 8 premolars found in an adult human. What is the function of premolar? Premolars help in crushing and grinding the food. How many molars are found in an adult human? There are total 12 molars present in an adult human. What is wisdom teeth? Wisdom teeth are molar teeth that grow usually between the age of 18 to 21 in human. Okay, because they are grown during between this age group, that's why they are known as wisdom tooth. How many teeth does an adult have? A human adult has 32 teeth in all, 16 in each jaw, 16 in upper jaw and 16 in lower jaw. Now, what do you understand by milk and permanent teeth? Human has 2 sets of teeth. In our life, we are having 2 sets of teeth. First one grow after the age of 6 to 8 months. They are known as milk teeth. And they start falling when the child reaches at the age of 6 to 8 years. After they one by one, they start falling. And all milk teeth fall. The number of milk teeth is 20. When the full set of the milk teeth is having 20 teeth in them. Milk teeth start growing at the baby stage and they are replaced gradually by permanent teeth from the age of 8 years. 6 to 8 years is the age from where the milk teeth started falling, and in place of that teeth, more stronger teeth are grown, which are known as permanent teeth. Now that this set of teeth, second set of teeth in our life is known as permanent teeth and it has 32 teeth in it. So you can say that milk teeth, they are 20 in number and permanent teeth, they are 32 in number. Milk teeth are less stronger than the permanent teeth. Permanent teeth are lifelong. They are with us for our whole life if we take care of them properly. What is enamel? The white substance that covers our teeth is called enamel. It is the hardest substance in the human body. In our body, enamel is the hardest substance. It is covered by it covers the teeth. It is the outermost layer of teeth and it is of white color. So these are some questions based on type, function of types and functions of teeth and about the cavities in teeth. That topic already we have discussed. Now, as you know that the digestion process is carried out by so many organs, and we have started talking about the mouth. And in the mouth, that is also known as buccal cavity, along with the teeth, tongue is also there. Tongue is also present. Now, what it do? What is it? What is tongue? The tongue is a muscular organ. It helps to mix saliva in the food. What is the use of tongue? Tongue helps to mix saliva in the food. It also helps to push the food down the food pipe or esophagus. You know that the mouth is connected with the stomach by a long tube which is known as esophagus or food pipe. So tongue push the food in that tube and help in swallowing it. It make the food soft and easy to swallow. In spite of this main work in the digestion, tongue also help in speaking. With the help of tongue, we can speak. Tongue also help us to taste the things. Taste receptors or the taste buds are present in tongue and give us the sense of taste. But that means you can say because of the tongue only we can identify different tastes. Now here in this figure, as you can see, on the tongue there are different regions where the different taste buds or the taste receptors are present. This area, the back of our tongue, it is for the bitter taste. The front of our tongue is for the sweet. This earlier sides, these are front sides, these are for salt or the salty taste, and the back sides are for the sour taste. These are the regions which has different taste buds or the taste receptor. So the tongue help in the taste also. So this is about tongue. Tongue, which is a muscular organ present inside our mouth or the buccal cavity, it help in the mixing of food with saliva. It help to moisten the food. It help to swallow the food. It help in talking, and it help us in tasting the food also. Now, teeth, tongue, and one more thing is there in the mouth. That is known as what? Salivary glands. These glands are present inside our mouth and they secrete a digestive juice which is known as saliva. Now the saliva is helpful in moistening the food, making the food soft, and it also do the digestion of starch which is present in our food. When we mix saliva with the food items which we are chewing, it started breaking down starch into simple sugar. It do the digestion of starch into the simple sugar with the help of an enzyme which is known as amylase or the salivary amylase. So you can see that the process of digestion started from the mouth only. Here the saliva digest the starch which is present in the food. After the buccal cavity, the next organ which is in the digestive system or the digestive tract is oesophagus. This is oesophagus. What is it? It is a muscular pipe which joins mouth with the stomach. In the next class, we will study about what is its function. Its main function is what? It transfer food from mouth to stomach. But in detail, how it transfer, how the food goes in from upwards to the downwards, this we will discuss in the next class.